we start with some transfer news that will really please Liverpool fans, because Liverpool are close to agreeing a deal with Bayern Munich for Thiago Alcantara. The initial fee is around £22 million. He's in the final year of his contract. It had initially looked like any deal would be dependent on the future of Gini Wijnaldum, who's also in his final year of his contract at Anfield. But Liverpool have decided to make their move now. And all through these shows, Liverpool fans have been getting in touch on hashtag transfer talk, saying that they want Thiago. This will go down well. Let us know what you think. And we will discuss this in more detail later this hour. But we've got to get to Gareth Bale now. What a story this is. Tottenham are getting closer to signing him from Real Madrid on loan. Let's head out to the Spanish capital now, because Ben Ransom is at the club's training ground for us. Ben, this appears to be gathering speed. In the last half an hour, you've seen Bale.
I have indeed. I must admit, it was as much a shock to me as it was to the other five or six TV crews that were stood positioned here at the entrance to Real Madrid's training ground, because quite simply, no one here in Madrid, none of the local reporters, expected to see Gareth Bale arrive here this morning. But at around 10:15, he did just that. We saw him drive in, give a little wave as he turned through and passed the security and inside the training ground. So he's been in there now for around 45 minutes or so as we get closer. That's certainly the noises that we're getting out of Gareth Bale's camp, those close to him telling us that this signing is getting closer. Remember, he's got 2 years left on his deal here at Real Madrid. He's looking to move to Tottenham on loan, and Tottenham would have to find something in the region of £20 million to cover loan fees and wages. So nothing untoward, no suggestion that him turning us to the training ground has got anything that's going to derail this deal. We do still expect it to happen. However, big news, and as I say, a bit of shock here on the streets of Madrid this morning.
Well, it's a huge story. Everyone's talking about it, and it's developing so quickly, which is rare in a deal as big as this. What's your understanding of the move?
Yeah, that's it. At the moment, things seem to be moving forward pretty swiftly, don't they? And on that basis, I mean, let's not play down how big a move this would be for Tottenham. Gareth Bale was fantastic in his 6 years at the club there. He turned himself into one of the best players on the planet. It led to a world record fee at the time. £86 million brought him here 7 years ago. His career started brilliantly, didn't he? I mean, here he's had a great track record in that he's scored in Champions League finals, but recently things have just gone off the boil for him here. That relationship with Zinedine Zidane appears to have broken down completely. Bale's been frozen out. The pair just don't seem to see eye to eye. And we've seen a reduction in the number of appearances for the club, a number of key moments that he's been involved in. I think he played just 20 times for them last season. Clearly, his future lies elsewhere. Up until this summer, Bale had always said, look, I'm open to options, but ultimately, I won't be forced out anywhere I don't want to go. I think he sees this Tottenham move as a move that could really reignite his career. Certainly the noises coming from those close to him suggest that he really believes that he can play for a club again that believes in him, that respects him, that appreciates what he can offer. And at 31 years old, he's still got plenty to offer a team in the Premier League.
Well, this could be a brilliant day for Tottenham fans. And you're in the right place here, because there's another outgoing from Real Madrid. Tell us about Sergio Reguilón.
Yeah, could it be one former Tottenham left-back and perhaps a future Tottenham left-back? Well, it certainly looks that way, because as we understand it, a deal has now been agreed between Tottenham and Real Madrid for Sergio Reguilón, the left-back who impressed so much in La Liga last season, closing in on a move to Tottenham. We understand he's having a medical here in Madrid today. Similarly, Gareth Bale's medical could well take place here in Madrid. Both deals then are separate, but assuming those medicals go through with no hitches whatsoever, certainly in the case of Reguilón, we then expect him to fly to London to finalise the deal. So really exciting times. Tottenham fans, Michael Bridge, I'm sure, will be absolutely loving this, because lots going on at Spurs and potentially a really significant day.
Yeah, it certainly is, Ben. Thank you. I remember that Michael Bridge said he would shave his head if this Gareth Bale join move happened. Club. And just a little update on that, he's phoned his mum this morning and got her permission to do it, OK? So it will happen if Bale goes through. Right, get in touch here, because this Bale deal, everyone's talking about it, hashtag transfer talk, loads are coming in. I'll read out as many as I possibly can throughout this. We're going to introduce Anton and JD now, because these two disagree on this deal, all right? Completely. Usually, so much prep goes in to this, and you write all your notes down. They're there. They're in the rundown for them to look at. Today, they've put them in at the last minute because they don't want to see each other's argument, all right? This could be quite entertaining. JD is going to start by talking about the pros of this deal.
I mean, to be honest, I don't want to tell the general public what to do, but the man sitting over there, he doesn't have a clue as to what Spurs needs, because Gareth Bale is exactly what Spurs need. After watching that game on Sunday, Anton, I'd love for you to tell me how you do not believe that that team doesn't need someone who can go and win them a game with individual brilliance, creativity and flair. Tell me over the last 10 years that hasn't been Gareth Bale's career. Look, let's forget the facts. Let's forget the fact that he has scored more than 100 league goals for both Spurs and Real Madrid, the four Champions League titles, the double figures in terms of those goal-scoring seasons in Real Madrid. I'm just going to remind you of some of those standout moments, yeah? I want to take you back. Do you remember the Copa del Rey? Do you remember how he, let's just say, embarrassed Marc Bartra, skipped round him, out-sprinted him down the halfway line, then coolly tinked it over Pinto and reminded everybody of his class? I'll then fast forward again to fans more recently. We think about the 2018 Champions League final, that overhead kick that has been synonymous with Gareth Bale. And if you forget about some of the stuff he did in the Real Madrid shirt, I'm just going to remind you of that night against Inter Milan and how Maicon at that moment in time was considered one of the best right-backs in the world, and he showed him why class is permanent. Now, Spurs fans, I want you to remember one thing. The footballer that probably will come to Spurs this season, we're all hoping, will probably not be the same player. But I said one thing that was really important in that whole segment that Anton is not going to take on. Class is permanent, my friend. So at 31 years old, Gareth Bale is exactly what Spurs need.
OK, it's a strong argument there, because JD is very much for this deal, thinks it's excellent for Tottenham. Anton, not so much. Wait, take it away, Anton.
I love you, JD. I love working with you. You're like the Ric Flair of sports analysis. Ooh. You're great on the mic. I back you to win any battle, and you look good delivering what you've got to say. I'll give you all that. But my friend, I am Shawn Michaels. This is WrestleMania 24, and I'm about to deliver sweet chin music to your argument,
Tell me, friend.
Because, yes, I will put some respect on Gareth Bale's name. He is a four-time Champions League winner. You can never take that away from him. And yeah, what a surprise. You point to the Champions League final 2 years ago, where Bale was magnificent. Man of the match, scored twice. We all remember this. But remember this, Gareth Bale was a substitute that night. Zinedine Zidane didn't even think he was worthy of the starting 11 then. He picked Isco. Peak Gareth Bale was 6 years ago. You want to go back to 2014? Nostalgia is as comforting as a warm blanket on a chilly winter's day. But let's look at the cold, hard facts. Let's compare peak Gareth Bale in 2014 to the man that he has been recently. He averaged 5.8 dribbles a game back in 2014. Last season, it was half that, at 2.9. This, my friend, is a statistical smackdown, by the way. In 2014, peak Gareth Bale averaged almost 4 shots a game. That is down more than 25% these days. Gareth Bale has only started in more than 50% of Real Madrid's fixtures in 3 of his 7 seasons in Spain. Peak Gareth Bale in 2014 only started 60% that season. Last year, he started 27% of games. That, my friend, is not elite. That, my friend, well, you have to question, is that worth breaking your wage structure for? Let's not talk about golf, let's talk about goals, because believe me, that will not take long. It will not take long at all. Last season, he scored just 3 of them. If you want to go back to 2014, that's absolutely fine. Go listen to Meghan Trainor about moan about the finale of How I Met Your Mother. Me, I'll look to the future, my friend. And the future is questionable, because Gareth Bale hasn't produced at the same level, you're right, we know he's capable of.
OK, most of the tweets coming in, by the way, are from Manchester United fans, either saying, why haven't we gone for him, or we've let Tottenham have him. That's most of the tweets at the moment. But Tottenham fans, we want to hear from you. Do you agree this is a great signing, like JD is saying, or his best years behind him, as Anton is saying? There is a question, JD, here, on the Manchester United side, because they're the fans who are actually getting in touch rather than Tottenham at the moment. Does this mean that Manchester United either don't want him anymore or have decided that they're putting all their eggs in another basket?
I think from the Man United angle, you have to look at it from twofold. They would have learnt from, unfortunately, the Alexis Sanchez saga of bringing in a player, huge experience that comes in with a huge amount of value, but also a huge wage demand, and probably would look at it and say that doesn't fit the mould and the direction that we're going at this moment in time. You've seen the way Man United have reinvested in the youth. The whole point of bringing in Ole Gunnar Solskjaer, who's so embedded within that club, he would understand that bringing through the next generation, the youngsters, the Marcus Rashfords you've seen, Anthony Martial, Mason Greenwood as well, those are right now the priorities that Man United are focusing on, and those are the sort of direction they want to go forward in. That's why you're seeing them linked with Jadon Sancho. That's why you're seeing it being a consistent saga throughout this whole window, because they're seeing the age being a huge factor in all of the decisions they're going to make going forward.
Not only that, JD, I mean, let's be brutally honest. I mean, we heard from Gareth Bale a couple of weeks ago, didn't we, when he was with the Wales camp. Gareth Bale wants to go where he feels loved. And he's going to feel loved at Tottenham. We're seeing that, obviously, the reaction for Tottenham fans. You know, he's just absolutely beloved. And therefore, that might bring out the best in Gareth Bale as well. So it's not just a, right, who wants him, but also it's a what's going to be best for him individually, personally, professionally, and also, you know, in his own private life as well. And that's why Tottenham are at the front of the queue.
We've got an interesting stats to bring up that we can show you now, actually. You can see that he's actually won more trophies as a player than Zinedine Zidane at Real Madrid, more assists than David Beckham, and he was the king of that, wasn't he? And the one at the bottom, I know we're not... the R9 Ronaldo, he's actually scored more goals than him, which is the one that has shocked us the most. A few tweets coming in. Paul Marshall says, a couple of great attacking players coming in at Tottenham. Pity them that Mourinho's parked the bus style. We'll never see the attacking football they are capable of. Well, Bale might change all of that. And someone here called John says, breathe, Anton, holy moly. Thought you were going to combust. All right, keep them coming in. But there is another deal coming in at Tottenham. And we heard there, Anton, about Sergi Reguilon, a left-back coming in as well. So this could be a good day for Tottenham fans.
Yeah, I mean, it really could be. Sergi Reguilon is, well, he was fantastic on loan at Sevilla last season. If you want to know how good he is, go back and watch the game Sevilla against Roma in the Europa League last season. He scored a fantastic goal. He absolutely destroyed the Italian side that day. He's an attacking fullback, which I think it basically goes back to what JD was saying, that this is a team bereft of creativity, and it's not just in the forward positions they need it. They need it starting from the back. So this move makes a lot of sense.
OK, just loads of tweets. Yeah, go on, Karin.
Just a couple of that, Tom. Honestly, we look at sort of Spurs' lack of creativity they've had in the wings, especially a game against Everton highlighted that. And bringing in sort of, we've seen what Matt Doherty did, especially on the right-hand side, but bringing in Sergio Reguilon on that left-hand side will just add a nice balance. And it will give them versatility in terms of the formations they can use as well. We saw seven times last year, Jose Mourinho used the five at the back with the two wing-backs. It will give them a new dynamic, especially in the wing positions, a new creativity more than anything else.